and welcome to Mark and Kelly's Trips, Tips and Things. If you are into travel, food and reviews, please consider subscribing. So we are here today at the Harry Potter exhibition.
There it is. I'm just scrolling up. The Harry Potter exhibition. It's here.
I have my trusty mask. I have my glasses so I can actually see where I'm going. Let's go in.
Let's go in. Come down the stairs into the entrance, Harry Potter, and there's the cart, and you can see all the letters there as well. So we're just gonna go head down the stairs and into the exhibition. So one of the first exhibits we have here is the Harry Potter school uniform, and this was actually worn by Daniel Radcliffe in the film. So there you go, a lot of the props here are, we've been told, actually replicas from the film, so props from the film. So there we are, there's Daniel Radcliffe's school.
The lady had told us as we came in that they've written the books in sort of over 80 languages, which is just absolutely amazing. Now we're having a look at some of the photography right here, and here is Roy Fortescue, where Harry spent one summer doing his homework and sitting outside Roy Fortescue enjoying the ice cream. I mean, I love the ice cream. What about you?
Oh yeah, absolutely. My favourite is probably the apple crumble.
Oh yeah, yeah, the apple crumble. That is pretty nice. Yeah. And I like the PB&J peanut butter and jelly. That's quite nice. So yeah. So
to show you the universal appeal of Harry Potter, these are the covers of books in all different languages. So you can see there they've got Chinese, Spanish, there's Swedish, this is Belarusian. I'm gonna get a chance to get the line. And also this one, what does it say? Oh, Mari. That's actually Mari. And Indonesian, so it just gives you a real understanding of the actual worldwide appeal of Harry Potter. You can see here, Gringotts Bank, here's some of the actual props from the movie. So you've actually got the banking system, or the book that they write all the payments in there, and you can see other various props they've got here, images from the film, from the Gringotts Bank, and there, look, they've got actual stacks of cash that they used as a replica. I love as well, if you look around here, just how they've designed everything. It's very, very dark down here, but they just got the lights behind all the photographs. There's the night bus. So you do feel like you're walking underground. You've got all the photographs of stills from the movie. And it just tells you really about where they filmed it. Some really interesting bits about where they filmed it in London. For example, Gringotts Bank was actually filmed in Australia House, which I never realised. But there we go, look, we've got snippets from the movie as well you can watch.
Yeah, so now we're entering in to, you know, the Hogwarts Express part of the exhibition. So you can see the train, the carriage and things like that. So I think it's meant to look like maybe even King's Cross?
Yeah. I didn't spot that, so yeah, that's the theme going round. This, they've got these little peepholes there that you can just about see. Just information and snippets you can look into about the movie. And then this is more parts from the set, so again, more stills from the film. But I do love how they've done that. You can actually just have a look in. I can just show you. And it gives you information about the movie and each individual peephole as you go around. There you go.
Yes.
How good is that?
Yeah.
Now I've noticed this sign here says this way to ride the broomstick, so I'm interested to see what this is about. I'm assuming it's similar to the one that we went to in Harry Potter Studios in North London, but we will see. This way to ride the broomstick. Yeah, so it is. You can get your photo taken and doing the taking the broomstick. Sit on the broomstick, so they will film you doing that. You can also have photo IDs here. So I shall do that and let you know how it goes. There we are. We can do a group photograph apparently, so this is what we will be doing. So you can go to, once you've had all your photographs taken, you come here to come and pick them up, which is at the actual photo booth. So one photo is £15, or an ID card is £15, but they do two photos for £20, or two Ministry of Magic ID cards for £25. And here we are, just some more decor here. I love the way they've done the art deco here. As you enter the different areas, so again it's all themed with different types. So as you remember, we went through the underground and now we're going through to the next Ministry of Magic. So it's all that sort of Ministry of Magic art deco, and again more pictures from the film as we go around. I love the way it's all sort of lit up, so you can just see how that looks. But one thing to always look out for is you do see these props hanging from the ceiling, which are very easy to miss. So there's one of the replica ones at the top there. If you look here, if I come into here, the Ministry of Magic, you've actually got the Ministry of Magic logo hanging from the ceiling up there. And also from the Fantastic Beasts here, other similar things. So do keep an eye out in the ceiling when you do go through the tour. Some really good little snippets and bits that are easy to miss. Here we are. So this is it. We are now leaving Harry Potter. There we are. We had a good time. Enjoyed it. Did you guys enjoy?
It was so good. Yeah, it was really good.
There we are. So that was our little review of the exhibition at Harry Potter.
So we have come to Bunsik and just filming the outside. We're just in a queue at the moment. The queue seems to be going down quite quickly. We have a hygiene rating of 5, which we like. You know, I like a hygiene rating of 5. And yeah, here we are.
So once you are done ordering at Bunsik, you do have to wait outside, hence this big queue here. Your order, you will be given an order number. So mine is at the top here, and I'm number 79. This guy will ask you then to wait outside whilst we do our order. But there we are just waiting for our order. From Bunsik. Thing of beauty, look, we've got the two, so what, talk us through.
Okay, so this one is the beef with mayo.
Yeah.
This one is potato and mozzarella with ketchup.
Yeah.
This one is your one with mozzarella, potato and ketchup.
Yeah.
And this one's Samuel's one with mozzarella, sugar. Ketchup, potatoes, all of that good stuff.
Basically everything.
All that good stuff.
So these two are going to try them.
Okay, so we're going to swap. We're going to do a little swap.
Some little swappy.
Okay. Take those. You
want to
put your one in here?
I'll put mine in that one, yeah.
Okay. So they do cut, you can order these, what I say order, get these little sleeves.
Yeah, thank you.
And with these sleeves, it just makes it easier for you to hold them as you go. So Samuel's going to put his one in the sleeve.
Oh, look at that.
That's
wow.
Absolutely. I'm going to hold under there just in
case. Just in case. We don't want anything falling down.
We don't want
down.
Anything falling down here. Probably made a bit more messy.
Oh. Okay, so they're now trying the, I thought I was filming before, but clearly I wasn't because the camera went off for some reason. But there you go.
That's really good.
Yeah?
It's got like a cheesy potato-y. Oh, it's so good. It really is good.
Okay, so your one is ketchup, mozzarella and potato. And your one is sugar, mayo, ketchup with potato and mozzarella. Wow. You can just see that there. It's crazy. Would you get it again?
It's £5.50, but I think that's quite reasonable because you get potato and the cheese with it as well.
Yeah.
Really, really nice.
And you love this place.
Honestly. I can't come to London and not have these.
Wow. Okay, so Bunsik is just across the road there. The bus is blocking it, but it's next to donut time. And we're just across the road because the queue, which I'm going to show you in a moment, is massive. So once the bus... gets out the way, because there's a little bit of a queue here. My camera work is not fantastic, only because I've got my one with the beef sausage. Oh, okay, here we go. The bus is leaving now. So there's Bunsik across the road, and you can see the queue just waiting to get in. And Mark's already explained how they do it. So they take your order first, pay for it, then you wait outside, and then they call your number. Good?
All gone.
Wow. Samuel's one is just gone.
Absolutely demolished. Can't eat this with dignity, but it is really good.
Wow.
Now, it is Madam's turn.
Okay, so here we go. There's my one. And so this is the one that Samuel and Mark just had, except mine's without the sugar. But I've got to say, it smells amazing. And this one is the beef one with mayo on it. Part of me wishes there was a bit more mayo on it, but I said that before when we went to the food market and it was far too much sauce. So, the sauce! Let's try it.
Pick up for the beef.
The coating's really nice. I didn't get bite in the sausage yet. But that coating, it's never sweet.
Let's have a little look. So you can see the sausage in there.
The coating's very sweet. I'm a bit frightened when I bite into the sausage that it might be a bit too hot. But I don't want to burn my mouth, but let's see.
Okay, we're just trying to focus back in on you.
That's nice. Doesn't taste of beef sausage.
No.
But it does taste of pork sausage.
It smells meaty.
There's meat in it. But it's very nice. Salty. I think I like the coating better than the actual meat. So I don't know if I eat the coating and the meat together. It is good. I'm about to compare it now.
This one's the star of the show, in my opinion.
Yeah. Samuel and I really like this one.
So let's give it a go.
Feels so good. You're lying here next to me.
You have.
I really love the potato in it. The cheese is good. It's really good.
Out of the two, which do you prefer?
I prefer the potato. And Samuel did say.
Samuel did say that's the best one.
You did say the potato.
I think it's the most popular on the menu as well. I think it is the most popular.
I can imagine that actually, because I must say I really enjoyed that. Well, there we have it. We shall let Kelly enjoy those last two.
I don't mean I'll be able to eat the two. I think Mark's going to have to help you. But I'm sure you won't mind.
I think I can help. Mm-hmm. Anyway, that's our little review of Bunsik.
Ooh.
So our next stop is to go to Snowflake. It's this luxury gelato. Here we are. There's inside. It looks lovely. Let's go in. I'm looking at some of the flavours here of the ice cream. These look amazing. So they've got vanilla, milk chocolate gelato, they've got tiramisu, chef special, the strawberry, sea salted caramel, amarena, strawberry cheesecake, mint chocolate, lotus caramel biscuit and Oreo. Got the white chocolate and pistachio, snowflake, praline, hazelnut, they've got the caramel brownie, biscotto, Kinder Bueno, they've also got the sorbet, mango, raspberry, dark chocolate, watermelon, lemon and the chef specials. You can also get your favorite choice of toppings for an extra 50p. So you've got the little mini Smarties, hundreds and thousands. You can get an entire bounty bar, Oreos or the flake. There's the prices there if you want to have a little look. I shan't read them out, but there you go. That's the ice creams available here at Snowflake.
so good. You're lying here next to me.
So I'm here with Kelly and Samuel, and we are about to dive in to our Snowflake luxury gelato. So Samuel went for, what did you go for?
The Amarena gelato.
Kelly went for the mint.
Mint chocolate chip.
And I went for the, I actually went for the sorbet. So this is actually watermelon sorbet. So we're really looking forward to trying this. We're gonna give each one a go and tell you what we think. Right, so Samuel's going in for his one.
Maybe a bit too big bite.
Yeah, going for the cherry Garcia. Here we are. Is it good? It looks creamy.
I love Italian gelato. It's Italian, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's so much better than just normal British ice cream.
So yeah, that's a yes, and Samuel for the cherry.
Absolutely.
And now Kelly's going for the mint.
Yeah.
Right, yeah. It's not going to zoom in. Oh yes, it will. Yes, it will. There we are. So the mint chocolate chip. Here we go.
It's got the best mint.
Oh.
Controversial, but it's good. It is good. And it's not bad for the price as well. I feel. What is it? £3 or something? £3.80. So it's not bad.
Okay, £3.80 for one scoop of cup.
But it's not the best.
That's interesting.
That I tried, but it's good. Right, so here's Mark. He's going to try the watermelon sorbet.
It's, I went for the sorbet. It's good.
Yeah?
It's not a strong watermelon flavour. I thought it would be a little bit stronger. It's nice and it's very refreshing. But yeah, I think all three of us are sort of saying it's not the best ice cream we've had. The snowflake, okay, but not the best we've had.
Yeah.
Okay, next on our little cuisine trip is Creme. And here we are outside. We are just waiting to queue. We're going to go in and have a little look at the cookies. So we're outside of Creme. Kelly's going to show the lovely, and we, as Samuel pointed out, it's a really, really
Samuel
nice.
Samuel got the same one.
We have got the miso and white chocolate one here.
That's a miso and white chocolate. Look how thick they are.
Oh God, it feels warm.
They're warm
and soft.
What I love are these bags.
Oh yeah.
You're going to show. So they come in a little Creme bag, but look how wide, big, I say wide, big that is. It's like a big cookie pillow. A massive cookie pillow.
In fact, it looks like it's about to break because it's yeah, it's so soft.
So both of them got the miso and white chocolate. Right, so.
So here we go. I'm going to take a bite now. And yeah, here we go.
It feels so good. You're lying here next to me.
Good.
Can't go wrong. Can't go wrong. I think what worked with it, because it's quite salty.
Yeah.
Oh, it's salty.
It That's what I was about salty. To say. You can taste the salt in it. Mm. And it works obviously with the sweet and it cuts the sweet, but I don't know if there might be a tad too much salt. I'm not sure.
Oh, that's interesting. There you go. So both went for the chocolate and miso. Miso is quite an earthy flavour. So earthy, I should say. But there we are. And you can tell Creme is popular. Look at that queue. That is one long queue to go into Creme.
And it wasn't even as long as that when we joined it.
No, so it's a very...
Everyone's following us.
Yeah.
They actually can't follow you.
Trend setting. Anyway, that's our little review of Creme. So our latest foray is we are in Chinatown and we have come here to Zen, which is one of the street markets right next to the Chinatown bakery. And Samuel has brought himself some pork buns.
Pork buns.
And they, I think they're steamed, aren't they?
Yeah. Is it £2 for £3?
I think it is, yeah.
So £2 for £3.
I was expecting a whole big one.
And it's got roast pork in there. So Samuel's going to take a bite and we're going to see how it is. But it sounds delicious.
All down to you. Right, here we are. Look at that.
Wow.
That's what I want. I'm so glad you mentioned it because I thought it was going to be like the minced one.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Is it good?
That is what I expected it to be.
Oh, wow. I'm so glad you enjoyed that. So, Ashafat, they only take cash here, actually, at Zen. I think it's called Zen, because that's what it's, the name
like
there.
Yeah, it's called Zen, yeah.
But yeah, so the guy there will have the pork buns. You can see them just in the window there. He serves you through the hatch, and you've got the pork buns there. So, good little find there. It's just, we just happened just to chance upon this, and we've given it a try. So there we are. That's the pork buns, recommended by Samuel, from Zen in Chinatown.
We have overheard
people saying this is a really good restaurant to try.
And I'm looking forward to trying a crispy aromatic duck. Let's go. And here we are. We are now, so we've spent the day walking around, walking, and now we are at Orient London.
So we've come to the Orient London to have a little look at what's available.
I fancy a crispy aromatic duck, and as soon as I said that, Samuel was on
immediate craving for it.
He was like, yes, let's go for the crispy aromatic duck.
Thank you ever so much.
Thank you. So there you have it, the crispy aromatic that the lady has just shredded it. We've also got the rolls, or the pancakes that just come there, hot and steamy. There's the sauce by my hand gel. And also we've got some of the cucumber
and then the spring onion. Is this hoisin?
That's hoisin sauce, hoisin, yeah, hoisin, yeah, sauce. So there we are. These two are going to chow down.
Wow. Assemble it here.
So Samuel's assembling his crispy aromatic duck pancake. And a little bit of hoisin sauce. There we go, that's the good stuff right there. Look at that.
Look at that. You just roll it like that, or do you roll it like a...
Yep, just roll it.
Think of it like a cigar. He's going to do it like a cigar. There we go.
There we go. Okay.
Right, I've got to get this. That's a bit chewy as well. Is it good?
Was a good
try. Really?
Very good
try,
yeah.
Samuel's been itching for a aromatic duck, so there we are. I think that's a big thumbs up.
Beautiful.
So the hors d'oeuvre has just arrived. Look at that. So you've got the prawn toast, you have the seaweed, you have the spring rolls. They've got, I don't know the other two bits are actually, but they look amazing. I think these are chicken wings.
Chicken satay sauce, chicken satay, and the peanut sauce is right there.
That's satay, isn't it?
That's and the chicken.
That's
the satay sauce. Right. Well, that's chicken satay.
And what's this one?
Spring rolls.
Yeah.
Crispy spring rolls. Then you've got crispy seaweed, and then you've got ribs, spare ribs, and then you've got prawn toast.
There we are. So we've worked out what they are together. The guys are going to do, both of them are going to do...
What is this again?
Crispy spare ribs.
The crispy spare rib review. So they're going to go for it. I can't shoot you both at a time, so I'm going to shoot you one at a time. Here we go.
Three, two, one, go.
Here we go. Samuel's taking a bite. Kelly's taking a bite. They're both going for it. What do you think?
Flavor nice.
Yeah.
It's a little bit chewy, but I don't find it dry.
No.
So maybe that's because of the way it's cooked. I don't know.
But
I'm hearing a lot of nodding, and I'm sorry, herring, seeing a lot of nodding, and a lot of So you both sound like you're enjoying it. It looks juicy as well. I can see the sort of glaze almost like from it. Very sticky, yeah, look. There's like zoom in.
There's a lot of sauce on it.
Yeah.
I love the sauce on it, actually. I really love the sauce on it.
There you go. So that's a thumbs up then.
And I like the crispiness of it. I didn't expect it to be still crispy after the sauce had been on it. I would expect the sauce to not make it crispy, if that makes sense. To lose its crispiness.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really delicious.
Feels so good. You're lying here next to me. Oh, what a groove. You have no idea how it feels.
So Samuel's going in for that lemon chicken.
Honey and lemon.
Or honey and lemon chicken. You can actually see it there. You might need a... There we go, a little separator. Good.
Crispy, sweet, zesty. Beautiful.
Crispy, sweet and zesty and beautiful. There you have it. That's the lemon and honey chicken. And that's a big thumbs up from Samuel.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so during this whole process, Mark hasn't been on camera trying his stuff yet. But he's got mixed seafood udon, so he's going to try some now. It looks amazing, by the way.
It does, and it smells fantastic.
Wow.
Trying to get a nice...
Yeah?
It's really good.
You know that sort of taste you get from the pan when it almost like burns in the water, lovely charred.
When they've deglazed it as well, and it's, so yeah.
I can get that as well. I've also got scallops in it. So
wow.
Oh, really good.
Yeah. It looks good, I've got to say.
I would definitely recommend this. It's really nice flavour. I'm just going to try some of the rice as well.
So that's the egg fried rice.
That's really good.
Yeah.
So Samuel's going for the noodles.
Samuel's going for noodles. Here we go. He's wrapping it around.
Quite right. That was quite good, that was. Here we go.
So this is the pork.
Yeah, this is the pork chow mein.
Here's the glazed soy sauce.
Yeah.
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 What is this?
Pork chow mein. Oh yeah, that's your black bean. Black bean beef.
I'm glad I didn't go for the extra chili.
Yeah, because there was chili in it, wasn't there? There's the black bean beef there.
I don't agree with those.
So what are you going for?
So this is the egg fried rice. It's really nice. It's a little bit firm. It's nutty. Very nice. Really good. Yeah.
And next?
That's good fried rice. So I'm going to try it. This is the crispy shredded beef. It's chewy. That's very, very good. Not too spicy. The sauce on it is good. I like the crispiness of it.
And finally,
this is the pork chow mein. Now, you can see the pork's a little bit charred there. And I'm wondering if it's going to be a little bit tough. I'm going to try it. It's not tough at all.
Very tender.
Very tender. I love the flavour of the noodles.
There you go. So it's big thumbs up from all of us.
Thumbs up.
For the food here at the Orient.
Yeah. The Orient London. Is it Orient?
Or Orient London.
Orient or London.
Orient, yeah. We didn't even remember where we were. There we are.